On Singapore's labour movement and human resource experts are mooting ways to help employees navigate a new financial support scheme for retrenched workers. Our suggestions include a tiered approach for payouts and preparing affected workers for better jobs through coaching. The new support scheme was announced by Prime Minister Lee Hsien Loong in his National Day rally speech. Chloe Chu with this report.
Among all the announcements at this year's National Day rally, one was most welcomed by Singapore's labour movement. A new scheme to provide temporary financial aid for workers who have been laid off.
NTUC and the labour movement has been lobbying for some form of unemployment support or insurance since about a decade ago. And in particular, the last 2 years, one of the key feedback that came up from the ground and from workers in general was a request for some form of financial support, especially in times when they are laid off.
Details of the scheme are still being firmed up, but NTUC and the Singapore Human Resource Institute agree that the government must look closely at making sure the scheme is available to those who need it the most and the amount of payouts.
It shouldn't be too large such that it will discourage or disincentivize work, but at the same time, it should be sufficient for them to tide through the difficult period.
We feel that the support should be tiered in terms of financial aid system, calibrated to the needs of the individual, and also perhaps maybe linked to previous salary income levels, and perhaps also taking into account family circumstances.
It also needs to be sustainable for the country.
In many parts of the world, unemployment support comes in the form of unemployment insurance, and there's usually not just government funding, but funding from employees and employers. But in this case, the government will be behind it, so it has to be financially affordable and sustainable.
They add that the long-term goal must be keeping people motivated to return to the workforce. This can be done through safeguards like having career coaching or training for affected workers.
Before an affected worker can tap on this unemployment support, he or she may be required to go through, for example, career counselling, attend career fairs, and of course, attend upskilling and training opportunities before they land the next job.
SHRI suggests working with companies to do this, especially amid a rapidly changing job market.
Collaborating with private organisations and employers can really provide insights into the job market so that the training portion, right, the upskilling portion in terms of the programs are relevant, right? And that there are indeed real job opportunities awaiting those who really complete them.
Ultimately, NTUC says this scheme is meant to provide additional support to tide workers through, on top of other aids like private insurance and retrenchment benefit packages.